Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel and thank you guys so much for watching. I miss you. This is what we're gonna do, okay? I'm assuming you're coming to my video right now because you fried your hair off or you wanna know what I did just out of curiosity. So we're gonna kinda go through this together, okay? Your hair is broken off. I'm gonna assume that the bottom is like mine where it was really, really thin. Like you could see outside into the world, like through your hair because you just had very little hair down here. And your top is really puffy because your crown is just so thick and broken that it's not laying flat. It's kind of sticking out and puffy.
Wow.
So in this video, it's gonna be kind of like a story, an explanation, and some of my advice on how you can fix the damage, you know, and make it look better so that you can be more comfortable day to day as your hair heals, you know, and gets better and better. This is not perfect by any means, but it's a lot better. There's actually hair to work with and it's just in a better state. So I just wanna help you out, you know? So the last time you guys saw me, I was blonde. And in that video, I talked about, you know, my journey from jet black hair to blonde in about 2 weeks and all the damage that happened. I'll link that video down below and I'll link it at the end of this video. As I said in that video, I had a lot of breakage and a lot of damage. And I think at this point, which that video was filmed 2 months ago, at this point, I think I look like my older self. I think if you go to the last video I filmed where I showed you guys how I get that sleek, straight look, I look pretty similar to that, so that's good. Really quick to explain the color. After the blonde in that video, I ended up going to a salon and transitioning back to brunette. I had gotten a light brown color and I wasn't into it, so I eventually decided, you know what, I'm just gonna dye my hair back to dark because it just feels like me and it's apparently what I really love. You know, I figured it out. Like, I only love dark hair. Moving on. I'll link this color down below, but it's just cool darkest brown. So I had remembered one day when I was laying down that I have black clip-in extensions. And I was like, oh my God, maybe I could blend those in, whatever. I found a lady that did a lot of extensions. So I booked her. So I had a really puffy crown and I had, you know, the loss of hair at the bottom when I went into her salon. I said, listen, like, I really just want you to cut these extensions. This is the situation. She was like, listen, you're not gonna like it. You're gonna leave disappointed once again. I was like, like, that's not what you want to hear. So she said, let me just put a bundle of tape-in extensions in your hair. I had never gotten tape-in extensions before. I had thought about tape-in extensions, obviously. Like, that was the first thing that I thought of. That's just the quickest fix. But the price of them, like, I was like, I'm not spending, like, thousands or, like, $800 and up or whatever on extensions. Like, I'm not doing that. So, including the application, the hair, the cut, the blend, she even styled them in with my hair, like everything. It was $150, which I think is a really good price. She did that and I instantly felt better. Like, all of a sudden I had hair down here, but it was still so thin. And she's like, listen, like, I think you need keratin on half of your hair. So let me just point out really quick, before I even went to her, I had been really working on healing my hair at home. And I used two products that I think are incredible if your hair is dry, damaged, broken. You need to invest in these two products. So the first thing I would recommend is the Olaplex number 3 Bond Builder. This little bottle right here, it is around like $30. It's so funny. Hold on, my laptop's dying. What's so funny is when I first got it, I thought I was like duped or something, because when I had gone to Sephora and I've seen the Olaplex, they were like this big. What I was looking at was the shampoo and conditioner and they are huge. And this little thing is a treatment and it's so tiny, but it's lasted me so many months. Like, you really don't need that much. I would use that like twice a week. So I would recommend that product. And then I would recommend to my shower, it's the Moroccan Oil Restorative Hair Mask. So when I had gone into her salon, I had already used up most of those two conditioning products. So my hair was in a lot better condition than it had been prior. So I was like, fine, you know, my hair is in better health than it was, so fine. So I had booked another appointment to go get a keratin treatment done on half of my hair. The way that I'm thinking is, like, because I did the keratin on half of my head, it flattened this, but it didn't flatten this. Like, if I did a keratin on my whole entire head, they both would have flattened out together, and this would have been really flat, and this would have been just not as flat. So I feel like this one would have still been thicker than this, you know, because, do you get what I'm trying to say? You know, everybody always tells you use sulfate-free shampoo. In this salon, she was like, no, that's not good enough. Use a keratin shampoo. And I was like, why? So I went home and I really looked it up because you know me, I like to know and I like to tell you guys too, but I also like to know. I looked it up and I got to the conclusion that not only do you need a sulfate-free shampoo, but you also need a sodium chloride-free shampoo, which I was never made aware of. Now that I do know, I did find a shampoo that is sodium chloride-free and sulfate-free. It is the... I got it from Amazon. I got a pack of two from Amazon because they did not have it in Rite Aid. It is the Aveeno Pure Renewal Hair Shampoo. As soon as they did the keratin on half of my head, my hair completely went flat at the top and I no longer have the problem. Yeah! Like now it can kind of blend in with the longer pieces and it's not so obvious that there's like a breakage right here. Like there's a clear line going around my hair that stops right here. It's not as apparent anymore because of the keratin. And then I had gotten another bundle of extensions. And what happens is like after she put in, now I had two bundles, like you get addicted to it. You're like, oh, this is fun. And like, this is good. Like I could feel my hair going back to the natural state. So after I did that, I think I went back and got another bundle done. And I got two pieces out of a bundle. Like she broke up a bundle for me and she gave me two pieces. And she just put two pieces. So I have three bundles and two single pieces sandwiches in my hair. So I have, that's how many. So each bundle was five pieces. So I have 15, 16, 17 sandwiches, which is two pieces of hair taped to each other over your real hair. I have 17 sandwiches in my hair. When I had first gone in, she was gonna put the extensions like wherever she felt she wanted to. And it would have required a lot more bundles the way she was going to do it. I really only had a problem with the front of my hair. It was really, really thin in the front. Don't be shy to tell the stylist where you want the tape-ins placed. Just keep in mind that because I wanted them so far in the front, like I cannot tie my hair. I don't really tie my hair, it's fine. This is what I think. Do the keratin treatment first on half of your hair. Go home, maybe try to tie it, not the same day, but after you wash it out. Try to tie it and see for yourself if tying it looks good now that it's flatter to your head, if you like to tie your hair, and if it does, then maybe don't do what I did with the placement if you're planning on tying your hair. But with me, I put, like most of them are right here. I don't have any hair. This entire area, there's no hair. I placed three pieces, she placed three pieces of tape-ins. They start down here, like this is where the tape is, and they just go in the back, three of them. The reason why is because I noticed that when I styled my hair, back here was empty. Like I could see the wall behind me. So I was like, I need hair back here. So definitely look at yourself in the mirror, really, you know, analyze yourself and like look at where you really want the hair. Here's what I want to say about tape and extensions. I feel like if you've watched a few of my hair videos, you know that I'm like not shy with spending money on my hair. A lot of people would comment and they'd be like, prices and everything, you know, just because it's higher in price does not mean you're gonna get a good service, which is what I always would think. This experience in particular and me going blonde really changed the way that I perceive pricing versus like the actual service that you get. And the better this, the higher the price does not guarantee a better service. So what I recommend and what really worked for me this time around is I found a salon. This was completely by accident. This is just kind of me reflecting now and giving you my opinion now that I've gone through it, but I didn't think this, like I didn't consciously do this, it's just what happened. I ended up going to the salon and she's the owner and the person who did my keratin's her husband. Like it's a really just small salon. Because I was working directly with her and it's a smaller salon, she's very lenient with pricing without me asking her to be. Like I will never ask a stylist to lower a price for anything. I appreciated the fact that she was lenient with pricing because extensions are very expensive, okay? Yeah, she's very lenient. Like sometimes she'll say, oh, 150, like my extension. She's like, let's do half your head 100. Like, you know, I'm not gonna charge you for cutting the extensions. I'm not gonna charge you for blending them in. I'm gonna blow out your whole hair and curl it, not charge you for the styling. I've gone to salons before where they tack on like, oh, $20 for this treatment, you know, $30 for using this shampoo. You know, it's just like, it's a bill, you know? So this one is a lot better for me. And I recommend that if you're on a budget, to try and find a salon that really specializes in extensions but maybe is a lot smaller and more personal to you, and maybe like, you know, the stylist is more lenient, but that's not guaranteed. But it's just something that I noticed, and I think that that's just maybe something that you could consider when picking a salon to go to for extension consultations. When I take out the tape and extensions, there will be no damage. She actually had tape and extensions in her hair. Her hair used to be just as bright as mine. It broke, and she had pictures and videos. and she put tape and extensions and she took them out. And when I had visited her the first time, there were no tape and extensions in her hair, and I ran my fingers through her hair and I really looked and felt. She like let me. She was like, look. She could tell that I was like a crazy person. She had no damage, no breakage, and that's what made me get into it, because I think that was also something that I feared. Rest assured, from what I've seen physically on this woman, the extensions are not gonna cause any further damage. You just have to be very careful with the way you brush, the way you style, the way you wash. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this video, you find it helpful. Good luck to you. Let me know in the comments what happened to you, what you decide to do. If you do anything that I said and it worked out for you, let me know. Thank you guys so much for watching. Once again, don't forget to subscribe before you leave, and I'll see you in my next one.